Coach Uminsky, JV team riding a three-game winning streak and doing it the right way with solid defense. Grebe picking up the shutout. I guess that's actually a team stat, but that's got to make you feel really good when you see the team playing really good defense.
Yeah, I was. I mean, we talked last week after the Tolman game where it was a rough game. Thursday in Monroe was, we didn't play really good hockey, but we came away with a win. Today, I thought we really controlled all three periods. Didn't obviously get as many goals as we'd like early in the game, but we kept coming. Power play looked good. Killed off a 5-minute major,
yeah,
which is huge.
Yeah.
And yeah, very happy with the way the team played in general today.
In particular, I wanted to ask you about Grebe. It's going to be my theme in all my interviews today. Just how far he's come from this summer when I was watching him in tournaments and things. I don't know if it's the influence of having a guy like Coop at practice every day, but he's a legit solid goaltender now. He really deserved the goose egg tonight.
Yeah, I thought, again, I mean, he played well in Monroe, obviously to keep us in the game. Uh-huh. We weren't playing well. He certainly looked a lot better today, played a little bit more aggressive than he has. He's grown, and no doubt, hopefully, it's part of it's from watching the work ethic of Cooper. I mean, the work ethic of Cooper you see in a game, the same work ethic you see in practice. And that's one thing we're trying to get him to understand, to bring that same ethic, that work ethic all the time. So, you know, young freshman goalie, you know, hopefully this year is going to be a really big growing opportunity for him, because clearly we need him to step up.
Okay. It's still early, but I think you're developing a reputation of being a really good third period team. You've put at least a couple games away in the third. You're up 1-0 going to after the break tonight. And, you know, put it away with a couple in the final period. But they didn't seem uncomfortable, nervous, or anything. I mean, playing into that shallow lead. Do you feel good when you get to the last 15?
Well, I do. And part of the reason I do is because we've got 33 skaters rostered on the whole high school program. So, I mean, you see out there, we've got 11 forwards and 4D playing the third period. A lot of teams are coming with 10 players total. So we have the depth and the senior and junior leadership on this team that are working hard, playing hard. I mean, that's a big factor too, I think.
Okay.
They're here to win games, so they're gonna be more demanding of the young kids to play good hockey.
Again, I want to ask, I mean, does it change the way things go? Like, nobody ever wants to mention a shutout for superstitious reasons and stuff like that. But I mean, it becomes a bit of an animal when you get to the last 6-7 minutes of a game. You took a penalty, I think with about a minute and maybe 10 seconds to go.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to be the one that's out there, you know, making the bad play then. Do you feel that on the bench, that it becomes something that you really want to get? Like, you really get a little bit desperate to get that shutout?
Well, yeah, I mean, it's always good. It's good. Obviously, it's good for the goaltending. It's good for Alex. It's good for his mentality. Anytime you can put zero up, it's good for the team.
Okay.
You know, I mean, it's a goalie making saves when he needs to make saves, and it's a team doing their job in front of him to minimize those opportunities. Yeah, I'm not an overly superstitious guy, but I don't say that generally. I said it with about 16 seconds to go with an offensive zone faceoff, you know, about just keeping the puck deep. Normally what I do in a case like that, you know, 2 or 3 goal lead, we just need the puck deep. Tell the boys, look at the score.
Okay.
We don't need another goal.
Yeah.
We don't need a single goal here. We just need the puck deep. They've got to go the full length of the ice to try to beat 4 or 5 skaters. And that's all we need to do is just play good, solid defense. You know, back off a little bit on the forecheck because we, again, don't need to be aggressive. That's how it changes. I try to remind them that way instead of, you know, the old superstitious mention in the shutout part. I stick to that pretty consistently like anybody else.
Massive week coming up for the varsity team. And we talked last week about, you know, how the importance is pretty much equal for the JV. Mm-hmm. You put a lot of importance on these next 2 games, I would think.
Yep. Yeah, Sauk, we don't play Oregon a lot in the youth level. Depending on how you schedule it, they're not in our division. They're Division II or Division III. We see them with the teams I coach to some extent, but we don't always see them. Sauk, we play every year, 2, 3, 4 times a year. They're right down the highway. They're a Division III team. We're going to run into them in the playoffs. So you grow up playing against those kids, chasing them around the rink, you know, on the ice as a coach. In some cases, some of these kids play with those kids. So, you know, I know a bunch of kids down there that over the years, from my years of being involved. So yeah, absolutely. These are both big games from a varsity standpoint, no doubt. But again, these JV kids are here to win games. They're not any different. So beating some of these arch rivals, that's a big thing. It's a fun week. It's going to be challenging.
All right, Coach, good luck in the week ahead and into the Christmas holidays.
All right, thanks, Jimmy.